Hello children, welcome back to the new video. So today I am going to explain you about light and shadow. So to understand that, first we will make a puppet. I am going to show you how you can make a finger puppet. So to make that, we need a pencil, a marker, black color marker, a yellow tinted sheet and a Fevicol. So let's get started. So now firstly what I'm going to do is I'll take this yellow paper and I'm going to make a picture for the puppet. So let's do that. So now here you can see that I have drawn the image for elephant and tiger. So what I'm going to do, I'll just color this both of the images, then I'll be cutting them. So let's do that. So here now you can see that my puppets are ready. Now what we will do, we will take a paper strip like this and we will just turn it and we'll make a circle in this way. And after that we will glue it with the help of gum. So now here my two paper rolls are ready. Now what I'll be doing, I'll be sticking this puppets that I have made on the top of both of the rolls. So now here you can see that my puppets are ready. Now let's see the puppet show. Now here you can see my puppets are standing. Now I want to form a shadow for them. So there are three important things which is needed to form a shadow or to cast a shadow. The first is the light source. You can use your mobile phone torch or the torch that we have at home. The second thing is the object. Here I have used my puppets as an object. You can also use any of the objects and you can also use your hand as an object. And the third and the important thing is the screen. Here you can see that I have taken a paper. You can use a light color wall if you have one. So now let's see how the shadow is going to be formed for my object. Here you can see that I am taking a mobile torch. You can also use torch. I am going to bring the light source near to the object. And as I am bringing it near, the size of the shadow is also increasing, which you can see on the screen in this way. And once I am taking this light source away from the object, the size is getting small. So this explains that the shadow does not tell the actual size of the object. Now let's change the angle of the light. I'm going to bring my light source a little bit left in this way. As my light source is in the left hand side, you can see there is a change in the position of the shadow. Now let's move to a little bit right, which you can easily see how the shadow is changing. The place of the shadow, the position of the shadow is changing. And once I bring the light source in the center, you can see in this way. Now let's move the light source above. You can see the light source is above and where the shadow is forming. And now I'm bringing the light source down. You can easily see that how it is changing the position of the shadow. So in this way you can show your creativity making different kinds of shadow puppets. Also, you can share the images of your shadow.